After introducing three types of DC connections in the previous video, today we introduce in detail layout of a single bus DC microgrid. The main learning objective of today will fall on the three main questions. First, how a single bus DC microgrid is created with either direct or indirect battery connection. Second, what are the main advantages and disadvantages of the single bus layout? And third, what are the grid feedings and grid forming components in a single bus layout? Single bus topology is one of the most widely used ones for the DC microgrids, on the basis of which more complex multiple DC microgrids can be built up. This figure on the slide shows an example of such a single bus topology, where one single battery is directly connected to the DC link. Let us now have a look at the power electronic interfaces in detail. The photovoltaic solar converter is stepped through a boost converter. In a similar way, DC loads are also connected using a buck step-down DC converter, as typically the voltage of DC bus is usually higher than the one of the loads. A diode bridge in this example is used to convert the AC output of a wind generator, and an IGBT based 3-leg voltage source inverter is used to connect AC loads to the DC link. Now, which element is grid forming or guarding the DC bus voltage, and which element is grid feeding? The grid forming and grid feeding representation of the same single bus with directly connected battery is shown in this slide. On the one hand, the battery is seen as a large capacitor, which can represent as a grid forming by voltage source in series with an impedance. On the other hand, other renewable sources like photovoltaic solar and wind, which have limited control over their input sources, are modeled as a grid feeding and a current source-based unit in parallel with an impedance. Both DC and AC loads can be also modeled as grid feeding. In such representation, the DC link voltage is set according to the state of charge of battery, which is related to the open circuit voltage of the battery stack. The single bus with directly connected battery has a number of advantages. First, due to the direct connection of the battery, the DC link voltage is very stable and regulated because the battery acts as a very large capacitor. This also results in an overall higher stability, satisfactorily matching power mismatch between generating units and the loads. And the reliability is also increased. Finally, as the battery is directly connected to the DC link without the power converters, the overall electrical efficiency is also higher. Despite some advantages, the single bus topology has also some severe shortcomings. The direct connection of the battery to the DC link will result in a wear and tear which more quickly degrades the state of health of the battery. Also, the DC link voltage is determined mainly based on the state of charge of the battery, which is related to its open circuit voltage. As a result, there is no control of the DC link voltage. Such single bus layout is not expandable due to the direct connection of the battery that remarkably limits its implementation in a larger area microgrid. One of the main reasons is that two batteries with different levels of state of charge are connected to a common single bus, then due to the having different open circuit voltages, a circulating current is created. This current highly increases the power losses and also wear and tear of the battery. This single slide shows a single bus example where there are different segmented battery stacks connected to the DC link via DC-DC power converters. Let us have a look in detail to power electronic interfaces. These battery stacks can be connected through buck and boost converters to the DC link. The photovoltaic, for example, shows a boost converter to connect to the higher voltage level of the bus. Usually the PV voltage is around 20-25 volts, while the DC bus can be around 350 volt, as said before. This boost converter has a storage component via inductor that stores energy when the switch is closed and releases the current against the higher voltage when the switch is open. So it is feeding current into the grid. So the inductor is what makes the converter a current source as seen by the grid. Concerning the electronic interface of the segmented battery stacks, on the one hand, if the voltage of the battery stack is higher than the one of the DC link, then there is an obvious need for buck and boost converter, which is shown in battery stack 1. On the other hand, if the rated voltage of the battery is lower than DC link, that is typically the case in most microgrids, then the buck and boost converter is used as it is shown in battery stack N. On the one hand, the battery converters are considered as grid-forming components. Each is represented by a voltage source in series with the impedance. On the other hand, other renewable sources like photovoltaic solar or wind, which have limited control over their input sources, are modeled as a grid feeding and a current source-based unit in parallel with an impedance. Both DC and AC loads can be also modeled as grid feeding. The single bus topology with indirectly connected batteries has some distinct advantages. Since the voltage of DC link does not depend on the state of the charge of the battery, no circulating currents are created, and as a result, this DC microgrid is highly expandable. Moreover, the DC-DC converters between the battery and DC link are able to control the flow of power, as consequently the DC link voltage. Therefore, the system is highly controllable. Despite crucial advantages, the stability and reliability of such system is not very high, and it is more vulnerable to the faults in the DC link. Also, through DC-DC converters between the battery and DC link give crucial control support, they have power losses, which makes the system less efficient to the directly connected system. Today, we mainly addressed single bus layout of a DC microgrid. Two layouts were introduced, and their main advantages and disadvantages were discussed. The first layout was based on a single bus with direct connection of battery, which provides inherent stability but is not expandable. The second layout was single bus with indirect connection of battery stacks, which is expandable but has lower stability. Next, we address hybrid layout of DC microgrids.